Hey guys, welcome back. Bhagyashree here from dominresa.com. And in today's video, I'm going to explain you about the remaining part of W3 total cache setup and configuration setting. In first part, we did general setting. Now you only need to configure the option which you have enabled in first part. So you don't need to configure each and every setting. Now directly go to page cache, which we have enabled in first part. Now in general, select this cache front page, cache feed side, cache SSL and don't cache pages for logged in users and leave others as default. Save your setting by clicking on save setting and purge cache. Scroll down to cache preload. Now here just select this automatically prime the page cache. Enter the sitemap URL if you have. Select preload the post cache upon the publish event and leave other setting as default and click on save setting and purge cache. So here first setting completed of page cache. Next configure object cache. So here in left hand sidebar select object cache. In object cache you should leave everything as a default. Here just make sure that default lifetime of cache object is 180 second, garbage collection interval is 3600 second and then save your setting. Let's move towards to next setting which is browser cache. So from left hand sidebar select browser cache. We did all the general setting in first part of this video. So remember to watch first part for setup and configure W3 total cache general setting. So here in browser cache you need to configure general setting. So accept process 404 error, enable all the option. So let's select all these option. Here select unselect 404 and then click on save setting and purge cache. So now we did all the configuration setting properly. In first part of this video, we have the speed performance before configuring the W3 total cache plugin. And here is the result before configuration of W3 total cache. Now let's check it again. So here open new tab, open pingdom speed test tool. Enter your site URL here. So copy URL and paste it here. Select server and click on start test and now scroll down to see the result. Now let's verify the difference before installing and setup W3 total cache plugin and after installing and setup W3 total cache plugin. So here is the result. You can compare yourself. So the performance grade before installing setup W3 total cache plugin is B90 and after installation and setup you can see the performance grade increases as A96. Also you can see the load time difference. After configuring W3 total cache plugin, the load time is 256 milliseconds and before W3 total cache plugin, the load time is 580 seconds. Also the request here is 11, here 9 request. So this is about the speed test. Here we have completed first and second part of W3 total cache plugin setup and configuration. To watch the full video guide regarding W3 total cache setup and configuration part 1, the link is provided in the description below. So you can take it from there. So this is how you can use W3 total cache plugin to improve the performance and speed up your WordPress website. For general setting, remember to follow first video. If you like this video, then click on the like button below, leave a comment and don't forget to subscribe our Domain Racer YouTube channel to get videos on your request.